So today, Test Drive Unlimited Solar Crown shut down the servers for maintenance to address some fixes in the game. This isn't part of the full patch. It was to fix server issues and, to be more specific, improve the stability of race instances, significantly reducing most error message pop-ups during the end of races. This also applies to in-game save game pop-up issues, fix the majority of progression save issues related to roads and progression discovery, and improve the online matchmaking. Hello, Cat. Where are you going? This man's literally just got up, stood in front of the camera, and is now pancaked right there. Okie dokie. The majority of the remaining server and connection issues will be fixed in our first major patch coming very soon. And this post was at 7:30 a.m. this morning. They posted another tweet saying the maintenance is taking longer than initially expected. We are currently performing the final tests before reopening the servers. Thank you for understanding. This obviously wouldn't be a thing if we had an offline mode, which would be great. And since around 4 p.m. these servers have gone back online with apparently all of these fixes, which I'm going to check out in a sec. However, there was another thing they mentioned in the post, which is that the first live season update, which was meant to go live tomorrow on the 19th of September, has now been delayed until the 2nd of October. They also finish up that post by at least giving us a bit of an insight about the first patch, which is coming a couple of days before. So it should be around the 30th of September, so the end of this month, we should have that first major patch to the game, which hopefully fixes a lot of these issues we've all been experiencing. However, a few of them have been added to the game as of now. So firstly, the POIs around the map for me and many of you on the game at the moment don't save. So the Quarry Bay meeting point, I know I don't have. Same with the American cars and the gas station next to it. Pretty sure this one. And as you can see, I also don't have the luxury cars. So I'm gonna specifically drive to this one and unlock it. Obviously, I know the others I already have unlocked. And then I'm going to close the game, reopen it as I go on two wheels there, and see if they have actually fixed the progression saving bug thing in the game. I hope they have, because every single time I open the game, the luxury car dealership and basically all of the stuff over here is never saved. So let's close the game, reopen it, and see if it's fixed. Well, it actually crashed on me even trying to open it, so that's a good start. Loaded back into the game. Has it saved? No. No, it hasn't. Okay, so the luxury car dealers, the gas station, and all the stuff over here, you know, the car dealership, all of that hasn't saved. Now, last time, these events here didn't work, so we've got a high stakes event. I've not actually been able to do one of these yet, as when I went to it last time, it just kicked me out of the game. So I need a Grand Tourer, which is going to be the Porsche Taycan, because that is the best one. So entry fee is 5,000. We've got 13 hours left. Time to beat 2 minutes 35. So I basically just got to set the fastest time possible. So let's hopefully, we're actually in. It feels good to finally be able to get into one of these race events, as it just didn't work before. So my time is probably gonna be absolutely garbage. I'm awful when it comes to rain events in this game. Oh, I've just remembered what course it is as well. Yeah, it's always raining in this event. And this corner here always gets me. I don't think I've ever done that corner perfect. I know this car has two gears, but I don't ever get to the point where I can go that speed. Right, even with that massive skill issue at the end, I still managed to beat it by 10 seconds, which is good. The other issues that they've apparently addressed is matchmaking. I've actually played like one ranked race or one multiplayer event since this game's come out. I've not been able to do anything else. Let me try and find a normal event that I actually want to do. Let's just go to that one up there and see if I can actually matchmake with someone. So the thing is with ranked race events, I don't really get how the matchmaking works for them in the first place. To what I've experienced the one time that I managed to play, I feel like someone else in my lobby also went to the exact same event and it put us into the race, kind of how it does with a normal race event that you'd do. However, with the ranked race events, surely it would pull in other people from different servers and put you all in the same event, right? Like that would make sense. Is it actually going to work? Or am I gonna be sat here for like 2-3 minutes and no one joins? All right, we actually have someone that's joined. Only one person, So either no one's searching for ranked race events, which to be fair, we don't really have any reason to, or it just doesn't work properly. I honestly don't know. But I finally get to play another ranked race event, so hopefully this will go better than the last one. Probably won't. Feels weird. It feels weird to do an online race on this game. Oh no. That corner every time, man. So as mentioned before, aside from these apparent fixes that have been added today, we are meant to be getting the full patch to the game, which will address apparently over 300 bug fixes, which I really hope is the case. And to be honest, I just hope that they do make major improvements to this game. I've had a lot of people in my comments on here, on TikTok, just asking me, you know, how have I been enjoying the game? Honestly, I've been finding it pretty fun outside of all of these issues. I guess I've got quite lucky on the most part, although I have had it where I get, you know, 90% into a race event. What am I doing? Where I get 90% into a race event and it disconnects me. You know, I've also not been able to get onto the servers and stuff like that. But on the most part, I have actually been enjoying it. It's been very addictive, you know. I think it's where I've not really had a racing game to play and enjoy for a while. I really do hope that this update, that they do actually cook. Because if they don't, it's over. Like, I probably won't play this game if the update doesn't fix a lot of the issues in this game. That'll be me done. We've got to wait and see, I guess. And the final thing that they have addressed are the connection issues in a race event. So like I said before, if you're doing a race and you disconnect, you know, it's really annoying with like the servers timing out and all of that. Apparently that's been fixed. I don't know if they have, because obviously I've only done a couple of race events so far, but I think the ultimate way I'll find out is I still need to do, where is it? All the way down here somewhere. There it is. I still need to do this event. And this is gonna take me give or take 40, 45 minutes. So if I disconnect at any point in this event, I'll be pretty pissed, but it will go to show that that also isn't fixed. But hopefully that's not the case. Aside from all that, it's pretty disappointing that season one has been delayed until October. It's what it is, we can't do anything about it. But I don't know, man, this whole launch of the game has been just one big mess. And we've had too many games just in general in recent years that are coming out. They just feel unfinished. You know, they just have all these issues with them. I know people have said, oh, TDU2 launched with issues. You know, that was 13 years ago. Okay, but we shouldn't be having that really in a game. I know it's a different dev studio and all of that, but it's just been rough, man. It's been rough. Anyway, thank you guys for watching. Let me know your thoughts on all of this in the comments down below. Hopefully this patch comes in clutch when it does at the end of the month. And yeah, I'll see you again soon in another video, probably doing that long race event finally. So yeah, until then, peace.